Hi friend, I am Jaydeep. Welcome back to our channel Flaunter J. If you want to really aware of cybersecurity, then you are on right platform. Nobody will give you a proper explanation about the terms of cybersecurity. So intentionally, I am going to help you to stay away from hackers and get rid of it. Before starting the video, subscribe the channel. Previous video, we learn about Trojan and malware. And now we are going to learn new things from this video. A new Android banking Trojan has been found, targeting international banks from the United Kingdom and Italy, including US, and 5 different cybersecurity services. 22 instances have been discovered, but more are expected. The malware, first detected at the end of October, appears to be new and still being developed. It was discovered by the Clify, a Milan, Italy-based online fraud detection and prevention firm. Clify called it Sharpboard. So do not forget the name, that is the Sharpboard, name after the frequency of the word sharp in the binaries. Sharpboard is not found in Google official marketplace. This means it must be an ensuring it is manually loaded. In a technical analysis of the malware, Clify notes that it is poses if the deception succeeds and the malware is installed, it immediately attempts to enable Android accessibility services by delivering fake pop-up to victims, such as allow media players to have full control of your devices. If this is successful, Sharpboard has all the permission it needs. Once accepted, the malware can enable keylogging to steal type credential, intercept SMS services to circumvent MFA, deliver overlay attacks to steal login credentials and credit card information, and remotely control the device, because permission were granted via fake pop-up. Basically, the malicious accessibility services can read anything a user can read and can recreate any actions a user can on devices. Notably, Sharpboard also attempt a relatively novel techniques known as the automatic transfer system ATS attacks. This is the ATS attacks, and I think you are new here, so ATS attacks, you don't know about it, but I am sure in our next video we are trying to enlighten you for this. These techniques has been recently from other banking trojans such as the Gustav, explained Clify. ATS is an advanced attacks technique fairly new on Android, which enables attackers to autofill fields in legitimate mobile banking apps and initiate money transfers from compromised devices. The ATS functionality is contained in module downloaded separately from C2. Given its modular architecture, comment Clify, we don't exclude the intention of botnet with other configuration attacks. The assumption is that ATS is used by the Sharpboard to bypass the behavioral detection measure used by many financial institutes. If ATS is used on what is the trusted device, a new device enrollment page is not necessary. SMS-based MFA can be bypassed, and behavioral biometrics are not effective. Although relatively few instances of Sharpboard have been discovered in wild, Clify suspected that the threat will grow. This is partly because it is new and apparently still being developed. The implication of becoming infected with Sharpboard could be severe. So it's important, says, to avoid being infected altogether. This is not yet easy. The malware is new and not well detected by existing detection means. Apart from the DGA, for its C2S, it also uses anti-analysis techniques including obfuscated strings and emulator detections. The best solution is to avoid sideloading religiously without 100% certainty in the authentication of applications and the validity of its sources, simply do not install it. So friend, today we have learned a new things from here, so I hope you understand and like my video, so please make sure to comment down.